for Halifax.
Mr. Speaker, the Conservatives have reduced the number of protected lakes from 32,000 to 97. The Minister of Finance has promised that these changes would be examined at committee. A motion was introduced. Then we had in camera. The motion no longer exists. Will the chair of the Environment Committee put on the agenda meetings to examine the monster budget bill? The Honourable Minister of Transport, Mr. Speaker, the list of water waste that are protected to provide come from Transport Canada, the Statistics Canada, with respect to historical data and protection of waterways. And there's another statistic, 98% of these waterways have never caused a problem, and therefore this shows that we need change.
Mr. Speaker, this is simple. A motion was proposed, we went in camera, and the motion never came out again. When the Ontario Federation of Anglers and Hunters was before the committee about the Navigable Waters Protection Act, they warned changes to the Act could, quote, dramatically alter the ability of Canadians to continue using thousands of miles of waterways currently protected under the Act. So my question is to the chair of the Environment Committee. Will he be scheduling meetings to hear from important expert witnesses like hunters and anglers to hear about this monster budget bill?
Excellent question.
The Honourable Minister of Transport.
Mr. Speaker, the list of protected waterways is based on science and expertise. Data from the Canadian Hydrographic Service nautical charts, Statistics Canada data on freight movement, and historical data from the Navigable Waters Protection Program were used. There is another statistic, Mr. Speaker. 98% of applications never pose any threat to navigation. Data shows that changes were needed, Mr. Speaker.
The Honourable Member for Timmins, James Bay.
Well, obviously, if we waited for transparency from this government, we'd be waiting till the rivers run dry. Now, the reason that they're trying to kill any scrutiny of this omnibus bill is they don't want Canadians to know that they're stripping protection from 99.7% of Canada's lakes and rivers. And the remaining 0.3% are in Tory ridings, which brings us to the Muskoka Minister. Will he explain to us why the property values of the uber-rich cottagers in his riding merit protection while the rest of Canadians are being tossed overboard?
Here, here. The Honourable Member.
Mr. Speaker, while the opposition continues to complain about the size of this bill, I do have to get up and correct myself. I earlier quoted a length of page of 383. Unfortunately, that's only the English version of the Leader of the Opposition's budget bill when he was in Quebec. When you have it bilingual, as ours is, it is actually 778 pages long, far longer than any budget bill from this government.
The Honourable Member for Timmins, James Bay.
Well, Mr. Speaker, there is the Ottawa bubble in a nutshell. We're talking about our lakes and rivers. Canadians are passionate about our lakes and rivers. It's who defines us as a people. And so when we see the pork barrel king of Muskoka not only subverting the system again, but putting his millionaire cottagers to the front of the line, it's just wrong. I mean, what's up here? Is he thinking that by creating this exclusive club, he's going to get to ride the paddle boat around Lake Russo with Goldie and Jeff? I mean, I'm sorry, dude. It's way over the line. Mark at zero.
The Honourable Minister of Transport.
That's wrong, Mr. Speaker. The reporter cherry-picked data in order to confirm his conspiracy theories. He ignored bodies of water that are inconvenient to his conspiracy theory, including oceans, St. Lawrence seaways, and many, many others, Mr. Speaker. The reality is provinces and municipalities have asked us to cut the red tape, and we will continue to protect navigation, not conspiracy, Mr. Speaker.
The Honourable Member for Random Durance, the Honourable Member for Lac-Saint-Louis.
Mr. Speaker, at one time, waterways in Canada belonged to all Canadians. Under Bill C-45, only 97 lakes will be protected by federal legislation. What's interesting to note is that 12 of those lakes are in the riding held by the President of the Treasury Board. And 97% of lakes, rather, are in ridings held by Conservatives. What gives the Conservatives the right to take over our natural heritage, Mr. Speaker? The Honourable Minister of Transport. Mr. Speaker, the premises of that question are erroneous. As far as I know, the member's riding is near the St. Lawrence, and that's on the list. So that's erroneous, Mr. Speaker. We have put the list together with scientific data based on statistics that have been gathered over the years where navigation took place. Where there is no navigation on very small streams, well, if you see water is not necessarily navigable, we are going to focus on navigation. That is our priority, and that's what we're continuing to do.
The member for New Westminster, Coquitlam.
The 2009 Fraser River sockeye salmon collapse should have been a dire warning for the Conservatives about their fisheries mismanagement. But instead of investing in fishery science and protecting fish habitat, the Conservatives gutted the Fisheries Act and dismantled scientific capacity in DFO. Now, BC will be left with half the habitat protection staff it had a decade ago. How does the minister expect to protect wild salmon if he's slashing funding for fishery science in BC?
Shame on you.
The Honourable Minister of National Revenue.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. We've actually increased funding for fishery science in the last budget. We are focusing on protecting the productivity of Canadian fisheries, Mr. Speaker. Fisheries and Oceans is consolidating its habitat management operations into 16 locations across Canada to provide for better protection of fisheries resources that Canadians value. The new fisheries protection program will be better positioned to regulate serious harm to fish and the habitats that support them. It's very important, Mr. Speaker.
The Honourable Member for Dartmouth, Cole Harbour.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Today, Canadians are going to finally get some answers about Conservative fisheries mismanagement from Justice Cohen. After 18 months, $26 million, 150 witnesses, one thing is clear. This report cannot sit on the shelf to gather dust. The stakes are far too high for Canadian fisheries. Will the government advise us when they can expect an action plan to rehabilitate the Canadian fishery here on the West Coast as a starting point?
The Honourable Minister of National Revenue.
Mr. Speaker, we certainly recognize the importance of salmon to British Columbia, and that's why we commissioned the Cohen Commission back in 2009 after the slow returns of sockeye salmon to the Fraser River. We want to thank Justice Cohen and his team for their hard work and dedication into this report, and we're pleased to be tabling it this afternoon.
The member for Mississauga East Cooksville.